Wagner realized that to express his revolutionary musical message, he needed new musical means. Traditional grand opera, as he'd experienced it during his frustrating years in Paris, simply wasn't up to the job. It was too artificial, Wagner felt. It was too formal, nowhere near subtle or fluid enough to convey the kind of realistic psychological drama that he had in mind. The familiar division of operas into separate arias, ensembles, choruses and recitatives, so-called number opera, it had to change. Composers like Mozart and Beethoven had tried to break down these formal divisions, but for various reasons, Wagner argued, they hadn't been able to go far enough. What was needed was a new kind of singing that combined the immediate power of speech with the heightened expression of song, a kind of hyper-expressive recitative. There must be none of that pointless stretching out of syllables over many notes. As far as possible, it should be one note per syllable, with the musical rhythms imitating real-life speech patterns. The closest Wagner came to fulfilling his ideal is actually in the first of the Ring operas, Das Rheingold. Here's a classic example. Wotan is proudly showing off his new palace, Valhalla, to his wife Fricka, who, as you can guess from the music, is less than impressed. There is a melody in this extract, a very noble one, on the brass, representing Valhalla. But Wotan doesn't simply sing along with the tune. His phrases float on its surface, tracking the brass melody while remaining fluid and therefore more naturalistic, more like real speech. While he was writing the music of Das Rheingold in 1853-4, Wagner was still strongly committed to the idea of what he called the Gesamtkunstwerk, the total work of art. In this, music, drama, poetry, song and painting would no longer work separately but together in a true creative fusion. Wagner's reading of the ancient Greeks had convinced him that this was how their great artworks, especially tragedy, had functioned. And it was this that explained their unique dramatic force, a force which had played its part in drawing a young nation together. How different, how dreadfully different from the degenerate Parisian operas of Wagner's time, in which the arts were simply jumbled together for sensational effect. Then, around the time that he finished the score of Das Rheingold, Wagner discovered Schopenhauer. For Schopenhauer, music was supreme amongst the arts, and opera had to be about music above all. No other art could penetrate so directly into the devices and desires of the human heart. You couldn't expect music to take its place meekly with the other arts as though it were part of a committee. It had to lead. This got Wagner thinking. And it's striking that when he came to write the music for the second opera in the Ring cycle, Die Walküre, he began to relax some of his rules. There's a striking example in Act One. The fugitive Siegmund realizes that Sieglinde, the woman who's given him shelter, is actually his long-lost twin sister. Enchanted by her beauty and by the loveliness of the spring night, Siegmund bursts into song. Wagner is still careful to make sure the words are clearly audible. There's still no playing around with syllables. And Siegmund's aria isn't a separate number. It emerges organically from the music beforehand, and it flows on into the main current of the drama at the end. But this is real song, the expressive melody above all.
Sprossen sprießt seine Kraft.